Thank you very much for this lovely introduction. It is my great honor to be here. Today I will try to present some research, some case studies, which we undertook together with different universities in bilateral projects. We had started one with Kazan just last month in April, and the other two which I will present, one with New York and another one with Taiwan, were conducted last year, so that we would be able to discuss the topic of internationalization of higher education curriculum. First, we will mention a few points about the Bologna process when trying to highlight the importance of professional competencies of our graduates, which they are facing the requirements within global context. We are trying to propose some teaching learning methods which apply computer-supported collaborative learning, which has a potential to bring authentic experience into their classrooms. And as a case study, I will present experiences, as mentioned, with three universities, City University in New York, Tayen University in Taiwan, and which just started with Kazan University. With Bologna process, the focus was put on international experience of students to develop curriculum which are comparable based on outcomes which are agreed in an international context. Mobility of teachers and students was facilitated, was enhanced, and the definition of competencies of learning outcomes are discussed and set together in collaboration with employers. Recently, the focus within competence development was put on professional competencies. And within these professional competencies, highlighted are cross-cultural competencies, competencies for work in multicultural contexts, networking, strategic competencies, where we need to take into consideration wider context, not just national contexts. Our students are facing the requirements to be able to design, to build their career internationally, globally. In search for new approaches which would allow them to develop in a good way, and also noticing that mobility is only possible for about 3.5% of all students in Europe through Erasmus programs. We need to consider some other approaches that would bring experiences to their classrooms. We need to provide all our students with the possibility to develop, to be able to act internationally. Therefore, we are discussing internationalization abroad and internationalization at home. And this internationalization at home, it is a focus of our approach, that we need to think of methods, contents, approaches, learning environments that allow students to develop for work in international contexts. The results of European survey among 38 countries about what they do in terms of internationalization shows this picture. There are many options how teachers, how administration, how university students perceive internationalization. Majority still connects internationalization with something what is happening abroad or what is happening in collaboration with some partners abroad. And here we have exchange placements, work placements, strategic partnerships, degree programs, double degree, joint degree, international marketing, students recruitment campaigns, capacity building projects, variety of computer supported learning. With regard to internationalization at home, the situation is still not so clear, so the training programs are in place in Slovenia at the moment to develop higher education administration staff to be able to think of creative, innovative ways how to fulfill these requirements. In Slovenia, we have, since Bologna reform, many documents which are regulating this issue, this problem. But the results, the outcome is not as it should be. Students, when they go abroad for exchange, staff or students, they don't necessarily develop competencies which we are aiming at. So our Slovenian qualification frameworks follow the frameworks in Europe, and there is a focus on competencies to be able to work internationally, but the methods, the learning, teaching learning approaches are not following this in a proper manner. So here I would like to present today the cases which we did, our efforts in introducing computer-supported collaborative learning to provide sharing, exchange, collaboration in cross-culturally. In this learning environment, we were focusing on generic and subject-specific competencies. The main focus was also on digital competencies and networking competencies as one of the important competencies in strategic competencies defined by OECD. We believe that such learning environment could bring closer multicultural experiences. The two methods, the two environments which were applied, one was digital storytelling and another one was social media, social networking sites. The two digital practices are authentic practices of our young generations, of our students. Digital storytelling is something that provides possibility, offers a rich environment for sharing, discussing, developing insights, building knowledge, constructing knowledge, and it is also very well developed in teacher education. It provides possibilities for reflection, for shared collaborative work. With the technologies, storytelling could become rich in a manner to combine diverse modalities of expression. So our students would be using, when we started this, they were using a very common PowerPoint presentations and they were designing stories, multimedia stories with a very simple PowerPoint. Today's technology, it is more based on video technology, so our digital stories are more based on video narrative. And the second technology environment, learning environment, which we applied was social networking sites. For social networking sites, we believe that they could provide more student-driven learning, where students are more autonomous learners, as they would share and bring their free time experience into learning. Also, social media are more recognized in career development, in career processes, networking for job searches, for developing professional identity, creating their profiles. So when we use this in a such environment which brings together students from diverse national contexts, this is already providing networking for them for future, after they will start their employment. In Slovenia, this internationalization of curriculum was based on a project on a national level, and with this approach we were aiming to develop some common methodologies that would bring such approaches more closer to teachers. First, we designed a few cases, and then we were working on dissemination of those cases wider, through different channels to present them to teachers, hoping that they could find this a stimulating way for their own work, or that maybe they could develop, get some new different ideas. As mentioned here, we were more focused, narrowly focused on cross-cultural communication, networking, digital literacy, but this was in the support of diverse disciplinary competencies and general competencies. And as mentioned, important here is to start thinking already during the study years about career development, career planning. And all these media are important for developing career competencies. When we carried a survey among professors, among university staff, they mainly thought that it is sufficient when you integrate in your teaching contents cases about how this is dealt with abroad. But this, we know, is more on the level of knowledge. We need to provide development of competencies which could only be conducted when the knowledge is applied, used. So here we would like to make a transition from knowledge about international context of disciplinary knowledge to profession, to competencies to work within, operate within different international context. And so students need to face the possibility and challenges how they could become mobile in a way to be actively engaged and operated in different national, international contexts. They more and more they are facing digital work, distributed work, participating in international groups within their own office or traveling abroad. And as the first one was digital competencies, this is part of building these cross-cultural international communication competencies, applying diverse digital media. and here to focus. Employers expect from students to be able in cross-cultural teams, in multicultural teams, and they expect them to have experiences with mobility. So how could this be when the fact is that less than 4% of all students in Europe are able to go for mobility abroad? And students, what they expect? They expect to develop capabilities for career planning, for career management, and they expect to learn more about requirements of diverse employer groups in different contexts. So here we need to address different levels of curriculum, formal, informal, hidden curriculum. Teachers need to feel that bringing international experience, developing students' capabilities, it is not sort of transfer of knowledge, presentation of topics, presentation of different standards across Europe or Asia, but it is to provide them with authentic learning environment where students would interact with participants from different culture, so that they would share, they would develop competency to operate in such environment. So the case here was that we designed an interdisciplinary approach to challenge our students to learn in such environment. Three faculties were involved. From Ljubljana, we were Faculty of Education, Future Teachers, and then we also had Faculty of Electrical Engineering, Future Multimedia Engineers. From New York, we had a class of students from American literature. And our task here was to find what is common to three programs, how we design interdisciplinary teaching learning environment that students would learn tangible out of it. And us mentioned the three topics: digital literacy, digital competency, networking, communication in across cultures. These were the three sort of generic basic competencies which we were addressing, but the subject specific competencies were different for the three groups. So multimedia engineers, they need to learn about usability, about users' experiences using diverse digital tools. Teachers, for example, they need to have the feeling how to organize teaching learning applying those tools. And if we look at American literature, it was creative writing course. They need to learn how to develop narrative applying digital means of expression. The most demanding task here was to negotiate between three groups, and first of all, between three teachers, which we were from different disciplinary areas, but we were very keen on designing this experience together. And the agreement was that the collaboration work which will be conducted will be also assessed within our own courses. So this was not just something to do in a free time. It was part of obligatory course. And then we planned some synchronous, asynchronous work and tasks which were conducted, shared, but then multimedia engineers were more taking care of technological. Teachers were more responsible for how to present, how to lead, how to organize collaboration. And and students from New York, they were more concerned about narrative. We organized, here we have a group from New York. So we organized this group work, and a lot of attention was paid to the topic which could be conducted that would be interesting for our students. And the first topic we selected was My Neighborhood, that students would design digital stories about their neighborhood. So New York students presented different parts of New York. Our students in Slovenia is a small country with only 2 million inhabitants, and students in our course come all across Slovenia, so they would present different parts of the country, really. This was the first task. Students liked it, enjoyed it. It was not difficult for them. Multimedia students were a great experts in technology, while our were more experts in presenting, in developing the story. And the second task which we designed was around new technologies, how new media changed communication between peers. So the second task was more demanding for them. It was, how did the development of smartphones and apps change your communication with your peers? And under this topic, they designed all sorts of different stories, for example, about intergenerational communication, about communication, partner communication. Some of them presented historical development of communicational tools. And then, this was the one with interdisciplinary experience. Then we had the next experience, which was more focused on cross-cultural fluency. And here we had group, Slovenian groups, Taiwanese groups, and here the topics were completely different. To communicate between Europeans and Taiwanese, we expected some difficulties when we would be designing the tasks which would not be very familiar to them. So here we had two topics, and one was sustainable tourist. It was about sustainable development and tourism, so that Taiwanese and Slovenian students would design digital stories within this topic. And then we compared how the conceptions about sustainable development are different in Taiwan, in Slovenia. And another topic was, this was sustainable tourist, yeah? And another topic was food cross-culturally, so that students would present digital stories about typical dishes, presenting nutrition characteristics, historical view, and designing this multimodal digital stories. They use different narrative approaches. For example, they would design also the dresses, the environment in a typical traditional manner to present to the other culture how this used to be, how this is nowadays. So here I try to merge in this presentation some conceptual, some frameworks about internationalization of curriculum, and then try to motivate also you here to think of some creative ways how to bring cross-cultural experience to our classes for our students. Thank you very much.